Hey, Peter. Gregg, Miami, Florida. One of the questions that I get very often is, Peter, you teach to use your breath to fog up, to clean your lens, to clean your sensor. Is it safe? Because I've read all over the internet that it's not safe. Well, let's deal with that.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
The number one thing that I say in my system for cleaning your sensor is to follow a certain routine, and at a certain point, you want to change the temperature quickly, rapidly, so that your sensor fogs up. So I say to breathe out onto your sensor, not spit, and not super close, and then the sensor fogs up. And then you use the sensor sweep, which is one of my products, to clean the sensor. You also use a cleaning cloth to clean your lens. Now, you should never clean glass dry, because whatever it is you're cleaning with it, you're cleaning it with, can become abrasive. So if I just took this lens cleaning cloth and started cleaning the lens, because there's a spot right there, I should fog it first. A gentle, slow exhale. Remember the word gentle and slow. You're not spitting on it. You're fogging it, and then you clean it. So there are people that are very verbally mean, and they come across like they know what the heck they're talking about, that they don't, that say, don't ever do that. The acidicness from your mouth all the way down to your stomach will just eat the coating on your lens. It'll eat the coating on your sensor. Instead, use this fluid. The fluid is a chemical. You can't take it on a plane. It's flammable. You have to keep it away from children. If you leave the cap off, it evaporates and it smells. But that's so much safer than your breath. Anyway, let's go down a little bit more of a scientific route. Here's a scientific route. I have a pH tester. I bought it on Amazon, and the reason is, in my kitchen, I have a machine to make alkaline water or acidic water. So I need to test it to see, am I actually getting alkaline water or acidic water? It's a scale, 0 to 14. That's the scale. 7 is the middle. So anything above 7 is alkaline, and anything below 7, it begins to become acidic, and it gets more and more acidic. And when you get down below four, like 3.5, it actually kills germs. So at that point, it can be used in a medical environment, like a dentist's office or a doctor's office, and they can actually sterilize their equipment. That's what acidic does. Now, people are saying, you've got this acidic stuff in your stomach and in your breath, and don't put it on the coating. All right, let's find out. Right now, let's see if my breath is leaning towards acidic or is it leaning towards alkaline. Okay, now I just filled up. I took the thing off. There's a sensor on the bottom. I turn this on. Okay, now it gives me a number. Okay, the acid level or the alkaline level, depending, is the glass half full, half empty, in this room is 6.47. Okay, now this is a glass, a little cup of water that I just took out of my machine, and it's supposed to run between 10 to 10 and a half. And that's the alkaline level. In other words, we want the water to be more alkaline. So I'm going to put this in here, shake it around for a second, and within 3 or 4 seconds, it starts to read what it is. And it's 9.85. So very close to 10, 9.85. So now I'm going to let it drip here because I've got this equipment here. I have a little radio show that I'm doing, so this is the equipment that I use, and I don't want it to get wet. So, all right, now we're back down to the 6 point something. Now, let's find out, is my breath acidic or is it alkaline? And I'm going to breathe on this the same way like I would breathe on a lens to fog it up. What happens is when I breathe on it, the moist air that's hot that comes out of my body, I am, you know, 98.6, I'm alive, hello, comes out, and it rapidly changes the temperature on the surface of this glass, and it gives me the lubrication that I need to clean it. Now, let's find out what is the acid level or the alkaline level of my breath. I'm going to put this and breathe on the sensor that's on the bottom. I wouldn't be that close inside of the sensor. The sensor is actually farther, but I'm giving it the full impact of my breath. Okay, the poor thing, if I got bad breath, it's going to be like, oh my God, Peter, get away from me. Now I'm going to breathe on this for about 30 seconds, okay? If it's too long in the video, I'll cut it, but it'll be about 30 seconds of breathing. All right, the acidity of my breath is 6.83, right below the center of 0 to 14, which is the scale, where 7 is exactly the middle neutral. It's just slightly underneath the neutral part, meaning it is neither acidic nor alkaline. Now, I've got a little chemical here because I need to calibrate this every once in a while. So let's do this together. I open this up, don't want any of this on my machine here, and I pour this in here, okay, close the cap. Now, this is supposed to be a 7.0 calibration chemical, okay, you buy it to calibrate these things, so that this way when you're getting the water out of the machine at the kitchen, it's what it says it is. So I'm going to put this in here, stir it around. Okay, it is 6.68, and it's supposed to be 7, meaning that whatever it is that we read out of here is off by a half a point, which is totally within tolerance. But that means that my, what was this, 9.8 something is actually 10.2 something. So it's over the 10 that the machine says it's giving me, the 10. My breath, that was 6.8 something, is actually over 7. So my breath is not acidic. My breath is alkaline, if anything, or neutral. Put this down so we don't spill it. So those people that very verbally violent and aggressive, look at the comments below. I'm going to leave it on here. All right. Look at how aggressive, as if they are the final authority on this, when they're not. We just did the test. My breath is completely neutral. So there is no acidity from my stomach or my mouth. Yet all the millions of hairs that I breathe through is filtering the air, much cleaner than what you're going to get out of a bottle of chemical. And I'm not knocking anybody else's product, but I'm just saying people talk as if they are the authority, and we just tested it. So yes, you should always have some type of lubricant on any glass, even your eyeglasses, before you clean it. And a little light breath, no spitting, will fog it. Then you use a lens cloth and you clean your lens. The same with your eyeglasses. You don't want the abrasion of this cloth, cleaning cloth, directly on your glass, because it is slightly abrasive. So now this looks like sparkling clean. All right, now when you go to clean your sensor, you obviously can't get a cloth down in there. You'd be like a bull in a china cabinet. So I invented the sensor sweep. It's now 5-6 years old, which is basically like a swab on a stick. Like, remember the Q-tips in the old days? So now you're going to clean it with this tip, which has a cleaning cloth, a sterilized cleaning cloth on here, and you want to fog your sensor. So follow the procedures. Then when it's time to clean it, you'll take it out of the package and you'll clean it with the sensor sweep. So the point of this video is, yes, you can use your breath regardless of what the people like Monkey See Monkey Do 5,000 times in a row, they have read, don't breathe on it. Your breath is dangerous. It's not dangerous. It's completely neutral. Your breath is neutral. All right, and so don't believe it, the monkey see, monkey do, and that people become very aggressive, very name-calling and nasty. And what is it based on? It's based on something they read somewhere else. Well, I'm not telling you something that I read somewhere else. I studied it, and I just did it together with you to see what the sensor reading is for my breath. And that is the answer to, can you breathe on it? So that's what we did. We tested it. Now you know what it's about. Don't forget my sensor sweep. You can buy it on sensorsweep.com. Nikon used to have it on their website. Don't breathe on the lens and clean it. Why? Because the technicians there were following the mommies and the daddies of the internet. Some people are just raised by the internet. Well, I read it on the internet, so it must be true. Wrong. All right. And then Nikon in 2012 took it off their website on the area where it says how to clean your lens. It used to say do not breathe on your lens. Nikon took that line out off of their website. Think of the system that your body is using to clean the air going in, and then it gets cleaned again coming out, and the alkaline level is completely neutral. Off by a few points, up or down, is not going to make a difference. So people like to knock me. Oh no, that guy doesn't know what he's talking about. We just did it together and I proved it. The water coming out of my machine that says it's a 10 is a 10. The water that's coming out of this testing 7.0 solution is the 7.0 solution. So it's actually accurate. And that means the air coming out of my big fat mouth here is exactly neutral, and you can use it. Fog your sensor is the safest way to clean your sensor, and you can fog your lenses. You can fog, where's my glasses? You could fog your glasses to clean them, and that'll give you the little touch of lubricant that's needed so that the cleaning material, it does not become abrasive against your cloth. Now you see what I just did? I picked it up and I wiped it. I should have fogged it first so that this way it does not have any abrasion that comes in with it. Abrasiveness is roughness, in case you don't know what that word means. All right, Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Thank you for watching. Catch you later. Bye-bye.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching.